The Premier says it would have taken more than 6 months to drain Warragamba Dam to cope with the influx of water from the devastating storms. How the region will battle future flood events is now shaping up as a political battleground in the weeks and months ahead.
Glistening in the sunlight, a peaceful and picturesque sight from up high. Down below, a roaring, raging torrent of murky brown water as Warragamba Dam continues to spill into Sydney's already swollen basin. The heaviest rain since 1961, today tipping 200 gigalitres of water over the edge, significantly down from Sunday's peak of 500 gigalitres, which is the equivalent to Sydney Harbour. Today, the Premier was forced to defend why the dam wasn't drained ahead of the weather event, after confidential cabinet documents emerged showing the government considered lowering levels back in February, which may have spared some of the flooded homes around Windsor and Richmond.
We would have had to have released water every day for around 230 days to have had any positive impact.
The opposition today seizing on a war of words between two ministers.
Minister, in October you argued that more water should be released from Warragamba Dam to reduce flood risk. Why didn't this happen?
I'm not going to engage in public debate about water today.
If there are pre-releases done at an inappropriate time, you actually can make the situation worse.
It's a geographical floodplain. We can predict that. And I think we're struggling to learn how to live with that.
Experts believe there are things which can be done now to help communities.
That is roads and bridges above the 1867 flood level.
And while Warragamba is expected to continue to spill over into the Hawkesbury and Nepean catchment areas for the next week, authorities have implemented a backup plan to preserve Sydney's drinking water. The city's desalination plant given the green light, with our main water source now at risk from a torrent of sediment and debris.
We're always implementing contingencies as we go. And that includes things like desalination and moving water from system to system.
Ellie Walsh, Nine News.